breaks in the east, and a mighty army rises. Not an army marching to the deep and desolating roar of shells, but a mighty army of builders who go forth accompanied by the whistles from America's greatest factories. While their giant smokestacks right across the skies promise of a new prosperity, in a land where that prosperity brings a fuller life to every man who labors and who serves. And as each builder marches forth to shape his destiny, tens of thousands more go with him side by side. And so each one is multiplied. And thus America has grown from the combined services of those who plan, create, and build, each day serving better, earning more, and building greater values than can be found in any other nation of the world. Clarion call of industry sounds good morning to America's manpower. As dawn comes out of the east and spreads down the quiet streets, the clans gather in a score of cities. In thousands of homes, vigorous workmen rise to meet a new day and a new opportunity. The morning sun stirs the nation's workmen, prompting them to their posts of daily service. Follow the eastern sun as it rises on the homes of men along the great Atlantic seaboard. The morning light over the plains has waked the thousands who are off to enliven the factories of the vast Midwestern states. And along the sunny shores of the Pacific, men are on their way to quicken the beat of industry. In 12 great cities, located in every region of the country, the clans are gathering for the work of a new day. As the sun stretches fingers of light across the pavements, the early morning sparkles with the greeting of men to men. On their way to factories in Flint and Atlanta, from Tarrytown to Oakland, the neighborly workmen hail each other with the salute of fellowship. Along the roads to the factories, tens of thousands begin to mass. They swell the rising tide. Into the silent buildings flows the life stream. The great producing units of the nation's mightiest manufacturing enterprise await. The giant assembly plants begin to stir.
Marching with the morning sun.
In every quarter of the country, in a dozen great cities, the bugle call of industry has summoned a clan. Legions of craftsmen have joined to supply transportation for a nation of individuals. Along the main current of the assembly lines, light falls across men spreading to their stations. The stillness of the factories breaks. The tramp of many feet makes way for the rhythmic hum of smooth spinning machinery. Under the guidance of skilled workmen, comfort and speed and safety are built into motor cars for all America. All that fine automobiles are made of, all that the builders need, is ready for assembly. America is at work.